Well, we're here at the beautiful Electric Lady Studios, where I just finished recording my new album, Music. And this is a little bit already my home. It's the fourth crossover album we've been recording here, and there's good spirits here, and I hope this one will somehow have the same good energy as the last three ones. Album is called Music for various reasons, but number one is really to emphasize the fact that since years I really try to use my instrument to endeavor into all kinds of music genres. And I think this one is clearly the most adventurous, and that's why I call it Music. I think an album gets going once I finished the last one. It's basically everything I hear if I'm on tour or on the road or just at home listening to radio, everything gets sort of filtered into the what could work category. I just go randomly whenever I have a few days off into the studio and try to make sense of those pieces. Some of them work great, some of them don't work at all, some of them you have to put a lot of attention to in order to make them work. So it's really a process, a long process. Well, I was very conscious to use a lot of different music directions. There's certainly a lot of traditional folk music. There's some Southern American rhythms and Tico Tico. We still got the classical stuff, which, you know, which I'm very fond of, and which is very important to me, as well as you know, some of my favorite rock bands, from Queen to Guns N' Roses. And so it's really all over the place, but I think that's what music is supposed to be. It's all about connecting. Each piece somehow has to tell a story in the album. And you have to be very conscious about what you want to do with a CD, how it's balanced. In the end, I try to arrange or write or create something which I find pleasant, which makes me feel good or bad or excited or sad. Music is such a personal thing, and this album really reflects my personal taste right now. I really try to create a fantasy world, and I think the more you create, as long as you don't touch the quality of the music, the better. I think the most fun was really to work on Viva La Vida, just because it really gave me the opportunity to hear the violin not in one voice or two or three, but really create a whole arrangement around that piece, just with one instrument. The idea came first to do this thing by thinking about the harmonic progressions of the piece, because it's based on the same harmonic pattern all through the piece. And so I thought it would be a wonderful chance to use a pedal board for the violin, which hasn't been really done a lot, and try to you know, just add up violin after violin after violin, and to just recreate an orchestra sound just on that instrument in the beginning. I think the first minute and 20 seconds are without any other instrumentations, just me. And then, you know, just bring the orchestra in on the second verse. Incredible piece to play live especially, but I think also for the record, it shows the, you know, the musical colors, the intensity of the work, but it's you know, just a fun piece also to play. I like to challenge myself. I actually like to wake up in the morning and look at myself and say I'm proud of my work, because in the end what I'm doing on stage is just I'm showing them what I do at home. It's about the fun and the love and passion you have with the project. You can show them something good, and if they like it, they can go for it a little further, maybe even into classical music and follow my road a little bit, or they can just leave it. Certainly not trying to preach to anybody.